My dear students, welcome to the world literature. Today we will go through Rikki Tikki Tavi part 4, the real hands between Rikki Tikki Tavi and two cobras. Dear students, let's watch a brief on first three parts. Rikki Tikki Tavi is a mongoose who lost his parents and reached into a new bungalow. There he became a pet for Teddy, his mom and his dad by killing a snakeling. Rikki Tikki Tavi ensured new atmosphere in the bungalow and watched new corner of the building. Later, he went to the garden and met Darcy the tailor bird. Darcy informed Rikki Tikki Tavi about the stories of Yukat Nag and his wife Nagina. At this time, Nagina appeared there and had an encounter with Rikki Tikki Tavi. During the encounter, Nagina severely wounded and hid into the bushes along with her husband. A brief introduction on the first three parts of Rikki Tikki Tavi is over. Let's move to the fourth part of Rikki Tikki Tavi. The real hunt begins. After killed the snakeling, Teddy's parents loved and cared the mongoose very much, and he enjoyed complete freedom in the house. At night, during dinner, Rikki Tikki walked to and fro among the wine glasses on the table. From there, he jumped on the shoulder of Teddy. Teddy carried him to the bed. Teddy started to sleep quickly. But it is an impossible thing for a mongoose like Rikki to sleep before completing a serious task he has to finish. He started to sing his usual war cry. Rik tik tikki chak, rik tik tikki chak, rik tik tikki chak. While singing the war cry, Rikki Tikki jumped out from the bed and walked throughout the room. In the dark, he saw Chuchundra, the musk rat, who is roaming throughout the rooms. Rikki Tikki stood in front of him and blocked his way. Chuchundra started to shiver out of fear. He tried to run but failed. "Don't kill me, Rikki Tikki, please don't kill me," Chuchundra cried. "Do you think a snake killer kills muskrats?" Rikki Tikki laughed. "Those who killed snakes get killed by snakes," Chuchundra said. While talking, he pleaded for his life and talked about his cousin Chuva Rat. Chuva spoke to him about the presence of Nag in the garden, and Rikki has to talk to Chuva to know more about the Nag. But Rikki forced him to talk everything about the Nag. Chuchundra sat down and cried. "I am a poor man and I don't have the strength to escape from here. Please." At this time, Rikki Tikki heard a noise and noticed the dry scratch of a snake scale on the window. He understood that it may be either Nag or Nagaina which is crawling to the bathroom. Rikki Tikki searched everywhere in Teddy's bathroom but couldn't find out anything. So he moved to the next bathroom, which was used by Teddy's mom. From there, he heard the whispering sound of Nag and his wife Nagina. "You have to go inside and kill Big Man who killed Karate. Once all members in the bungalow died, Rikki Tikki will go somewhere and we will become the owner of the garden. Once you finished everything, come back and inform me. We will attack Rikki Tikki together," Nagina said. "What is the use of killing humans? I can't understand," Nag said. "When no one was there in the bungalow, we were the king and queen of the garden. If you killed all humans in the bungalow, Rikki Tikki will go somewhere. Remember, tomorrow all the eggs will hatch and our children need more rooms." At this time, Rikki Tikki saw the crawling head of Nag through the sluice. Nag entered into the bathroom and drank water from the jar. Rikki Tikki fearfully watched such a big 5 feet cobra. This is the first time in his life he is seeing this much big cobra. Nag coiled into the bathroom jar and said, "I will wait for him till the morning. If I go straightly now and attack the big man, he will beat me with stick. So I will wait for him till the morning. In the morning, he will come here for bathing," Nag said to Nagina. But Rikki didn't hear any response from outside. So he understood that Nagina left from there. After some time, Nag started to sleep. Rikki Tikki fearfully looked at him. He searched for a good part in his body for a hard bite. If he bite on the back, it will be easier for him to attack back. "So I should have to bite nearby the head," Rikki planned. Then he had a quick jump and bit on his head. Nag woke up from the sleep and wriggled for an escape. He tried to shake his head to remove Rikki's tight hold. "It is paining too much." Nag struggled to regain his life. While wriggling, his head and tail banged here and there. Many things kept there, fell and rolled around. The big man heard the noise from the bathroom. He brought the gun and shot on the hood of Cobra. Here is the end of Nag. My dear students, wait for the more adventure stories of Nag and Rikki Tikki Tavi. This is the end of part 4 and wait for part 5, Rikki Tikki Tavi. Well, just tell me what you want.